Welcome back to my home. I'm Chris Myers from the Cozy Club, and I'm here to show you another recipe that I hope you will enjoy. Today is a very overcast day, and it makes you kind of feel, hopefully not fallish or autumny, but it does have a bit of a chill in the air, and it gives you the idea for dinner you might want to make something that's very comforting. So that's what I'm planning on doing. However, before we go, I am dying to show you what I've been doing here, which is really quite fun. I have this apple tree. It's called Kati apple or Kati apple. It's a Swedish apple tree. It ripens very early in the fall. And I bought it as a sapling when we used to live in North London 20 years ago. I dug it out and brought it home with me here. Planted it, and it just gives me the most wonderful fruit, makes great applesauce, anything. It's wonderful. But this year, I kept meaning to do this, but I thought this might be kind of fun, and you can still do it. You've got time because apples are just ripening up. I put a sticker on the apple because when it gets really big, the air isn't going to, or the light rather, isn't getting to the apple. So underneath here, check this out, is a heart. And then when they're all ripe, can you imagine? I've got them all little stickers all over the place. But I'm going to put this back on, and then it will be so sweet in a bowl. Can you imagine giving that to somebody? A bowl of apples with hearts on it. Love it. Anyway, that was just a little bit of an aside. Since tomatoes are now in season, everyone is going to be making tons of tomatoes. Come check out my tomato plants. I'm really thrilled with them this year. They aren't ripened yet, however, you can see that they're growing, and they're soon going to be giving me tons and tons of tomatoes, and I just love cooking with them, and just smelling, just when you rub your hands on the leaves, it's just such a gorgeous, fresh, clean smell. It's wonderful. So today I'm going to show you how to make a roasted tomato soup. Very simple, very economical, quick and easy, and it truly is delicious, even if I say so myself.
I love it too.
Yeah, you too. So come on in and cozy up. Come on. This mat I found in the most delightful shop in Nova Scotia called My Home Bay, and it gives me such a warm feeling every time I read it. So hello there, Nova Scotians. Come on in. Here we go. So can you see well enough? Because I've got the lights
on. No, I'm happy.
Okay, good. So what we're going to do is a roasted tomato soup. Very simple. You only need a few ingredients. You need tomatoes, onions, garlic if you like garlic, and salt and pepper. And a little bit of sugar, and that is it. So, all you need to do right now, is find a roasting pan. Now, just be aware that if you don't have any tomatoes, and you just have tinned tomatoes, it works just as well. It's very easy to do, as long as onions are a big, big thing, so you do need your onions. And that's about it. So all you have to do is get your onions. I've already peeled mine. So all you have to do is cut them in quarters. Again, minimal work. Throw them in the pan, that's all you're doing with your onions, so you won't have to cry. So there you go, so that's down there. If you only have small tomatoes, that works out really well. I just throw the whole things in. Obviously I've washed them before. Throw that in. And the tomatoes on the vine, just take them off. Now I use a knife that's serrated. It's much easier to cut the tomatoes. So just, I always cut the top off where it's connected to the vine, because you don't really want to have that piece. And again, I just cut this into quarters. So as you can see, there's very, very little effort here. Throwing all that in. I'm not going to make a huge one, because I've already made another one, a finished one, so you can see. But just to give you an idea of what we're doing.
The vine tomatoes are a beautiful smell.
Yeah, it's so yummy. So there we go. One more, so you can see. And that's it. So you can see that's the ingredients, two things in there right now. I like to have a little hint of garlic. I'm just gonna throw this stuff out into my thing there. Here we go. And I'm gonna put a little bit of garlic in it. And you all know I love Anne of Green Gables, so of course I've watched Anne with an E. And I don't know if you remember this one part, but they were cooking in their kitchen and they took garlic and they put it into two little bowls, and they shook it. And when you open the bowl up, it was like magic. All that papery skin is off. And I don't know if you do this when I cook and I cut the garlic up, it gets all over the place. And
it's a bit messy.
So it's messy. So I tried it, And lo and behold, it works. So all you do is you have the, here, can you just see that? Like that. Put it in a bowl. So you've got the same, so when you're shaking, it doesn't fall out. Shake it a few times. you can hear the little papery garlic
surface peelings
or whatever come out. And then, look.
Like magic.
It is like magic. There. Isn't that great? I love that. That's from Anne of Green Gables, of course. So anyway, I just cut them up quickly, throw them in. Of course, you can put as much garlic as you want. I just put a little hint because not everybody loves it, but I think it adds a little bit of flavor. And actually, when you roast garlic, it loses that intense flavor. It's just a very sweet flavor, I think. Lovely. All right, so you've got that. So then, your ingredient of olive oil. So you just want to drizzle the olive oil. I tend to use quite a lot because I love the taste. There, like that. And then shake it all over. So everything's covered up. Okay. And then you need to put some sugar. Now, a lot of people don't do this. And I think when cooking with tomatoes, it's quite acidic. So if you add a little bit of sugar, in something like this, I would put about 3 teaspoons. And it makes a huge difference. So just sprinkle the sugar on top, like that. There you go. And then a little bit of salt. Again, don't overdo the salt because you can always add salt later. But just a sprinkle in here. And that is it. That's all we can do. So I'm gonna shake that around again. And I'm gonna shove that into the oven. Now, on my aga, I put it right on the base of the roasting oven. If you just have a normal oven, you can check what your roasting numbers are. I wish I could tell you, but I don't, what it is for various ovens, but it's very easy to look up. And you will know your own oven as I know my own aga, so that's what you do. So we leave that in for about half an hour. So Alexa, timer for half an hour, please. And she was listening. I'll do it later. We'll remember. But now I'll show, I've already done one for you earlier, so I can show you what it comes out like. So, there you go. And that is what it looks like. So, you can either, all right, that's enough. You can either use it like this if you don't mind it being a bit chunky. You can puree it, which I will show you what I'm going to do with it now. And you can either make it into a soup, in which case then I do add a little bit of tomato puree in it to just give it a bit of color. I do that with the tomato sauce as well. It just gives a nice rich color to the sauce. And I'll just do that right now for you to see. Okay, very carefully. Can you get this, Neil?
Yeah, I got it.
You don't have to wait for it to cool. This has obviously been cooled a little bit. But get all the goodness. Now notice I've got the seeds in there. I don't sieve it. I don't do that either. But first of all, when you eat it, you don't even notice it, the seeds. And you know, it's just a whole lot of extra work that you don't actually need to do. So that's done. So you get your lovely little pulser here, which will puree it all. Make sure you don't splash it all over yourself. Put it in and then turn it on. There you go.
I noticed you're wearing a red apron just in case.
Yes, color coordinated. There you go. Right. Okay. So then it looks like this. And now I will just add just a touch, and I'll show you the difference of the color. To me, it just gives it a bit more richness to the whole thing. Just a dab will do ya. And there you go. Stir it up.
I like that Canadian, a dab will do ya.
There. And I just think it's a prettier color. Now I like my soups to be quite chunky. So it's all, you know, up to you whether you want it really smooth. You can puree it even longer, it'll be smoother. Or you leave it like that. And it's really, really yummy.
It's a very, very healthy recipe, this one.
Yeah, it's great with pasta. It's wonderful as a soup. It's great with grilled cheese, which I'm going to do another time to show you. There's a little hint with my grilled cheese sandwiches, which I think it makes it really special. But it's a whole meal, I think. To make it even more healthy, when you heat it up again, because you've got it in your bowl, just before serving, throw in some spinach leaves. And just before you're going to serve, because then they wilt a little bit, but not to the point where they get completely wilted. And it's delicious. It gives a bit of a crunch, and it's very, very healthy.
Very nutritious.
Yeah. So you can add a bit of salt and a bit of pepper, a bit of chives to make it look pretty. And then at the very end, you can either add some yogurt or some creme fraiche, or if you really want to be a little naughty, you can have some cream now in a bowl. It's a lovely thick soup. Can you imagine this with some warm baguette, a bit of butter, dip it in. Oh, lovely. So there you go with that. Just drizzle a little bit of that over. And just gonna get a spoon. And there you go.
Absolute restaurant standard.
And I'm gonna taste it and see what it tastes like. Mm-hmm. I like it. Hopefully you will too. Anyway, I'll put the recipe on. You guys can check it out and see if you like it. Let me know what you think. And I'll come see you again next time. Take care now. Bye.